Well, good morning and welcome to your Sunday Gardener. I'm John Collins along with Carrie Engel from Valley View Farms. And once again this Sunday, we're at the Mid-Atlantic Nursery Trade Show.
That's right.
Which occurred a week ago. We're here to show you the latest and greatest.
And it's a great show if you're a landscape professional. You do a lot of yard work, whatever. We come here and try to find the coolest tools for you to use and things that are really going to work, not something you're going to have to throw away after a couple of uses.
Right, and that's what we're going to talk about this morning. It's tools, neat stuff, right?
Yep.
That's right up my alley.
Tools, yeah,
absolutely. And this is a company that has some innovations, I guess you could say, and always looking for that. And one of the things that you see a lot of tools that have come out recently is a more ergonomic way, so you don't get carpal tunnel trying to trim and prune stuff or pull weeds or whatnot. And this is one of those.
Look at how everything fits. Yep, it fits easier. They have them in three different sizes. Mm-hmm. So whether you have a smaller hand like my own or a larger hand like a lot of guys. The other thing that's really cool is as soon as I go to release this, I don't have to.
You don't have to struggle with anything to open it up.
Because generally my other hand's on a branch or something getting ready
for the
to do
locking
some pruning,
device. Yeah,
so I hate to
absolutely.
Double play with it. But it's a great way to go. Three different sizes.
Heavy duty tool, but lightweight. They're learning the technology of making it so you're not carrying 10 pounds of.
Well, and a lot of that technology has gone into the steel too, so it's a whole lot easier. To use, it doesn't rust up as easily, I guess.
It gets gummy from sap.
Stays a lot cleaner from
right.
sap, exactly.
There are some other interesting things here. Now, this looks like a garden trowel or something, but what's interesting about it, it's got a serrated edge.
Well, this is a hori-hori tool, and it really is an essential. Master gardeners absolutely love this tool because you can cut those root balls mm-hmm. as you need to.
Right.
You can do some digging with it. You can actually cut through a root ball or cut through some of the weeds that you need to.
So it's got a little bit of a sharp edge. It's maybe something you don't want the kids playing with, but nonetheless, really handy for tooling. I kind of like this because if you want to do some spading, you don't have to bend over as much.
Exactly. And again, you go to those people that have a little bit of arthritis, and it's an easier way. You don't have to get quite down as low. I also like these tools. They're trowels, but look at this. They have this nice sharp edge. And in our clay soils, I can't tell you how frustrating it is to go in with a dull tool and try to do some teeing.
Plus, it's got an interesting little notch there at the tip.
And that'll help break through some of those roots as you go down and try to get rid of that dandelion root or whatever. You mm-hmm. can kind of just cut right through it and get ready to go.
A small scythe, I guess you call it. Again, for cutting weeds.
And size, exactly, yeah. Just to keep everything cleaned up.
But a small size for the smaller part of the garden patch, rather
than
getting
a large
thing.
I'll tell you, this is a simple thing, but this is an essential. Every one of our greenhouse staff has a pair of these scissors, and they're great for deadheading plants. They're cool for bonsai, which is why we originally got them.
Mm-hmm.
But even going out in the rose garden, doing any kind of cut flowers.
Because of the small size of the cuttingage. And for houseplants, this
for
time
houseplants.
Of year.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
And every one of our staff ends up with a pair of these as they get to stay around a while. And all the folding, different pruning saws and everything are also great to have.
Right up to the massive size. I haven't figured out how to unlock this and get it out, but it's a rather large pruning saw,
right.
I guess you could say. About as big as you get before you go to a chainsaw level.
And see if you want to do some of that fine topiary out there in your garden here.
Oh,
you
know, that's a nice long handle with a nice reach, but it's a very fine...
And what I like about these tools, again, is they're relatively lightweight, so you're not going to bog yourself mm-hmm. down out in the garden and wear yourself out from picking the tools up.
Right, then they go all the way to these large ones here that are on poles that have a lot of reach. There's one over there that goes way high. lots of interesting things. So when you go to the store, go look at some of the new interesting stuff. I think that's what we're saying.
And pick them up and feel them in your hand and make mm-hmm. sure before you buy any of them that they're comfortable, because when you're a gardener and you're out there for a couple of hours at a time, you can really get fatigued if you don't have the right tool for the job.
Carrie, thanks for joining us.
Thank
a few
you.
Tips on some of the new stuff that's out there today that's intended for your garden. We'll be back next Sunday right here with more.
There you go. Okay.
About the latest and greatest for your garden on Sunday Gardener. See you then.
And if you have a gardening question, send it to Sunday Gardener, WBAL-TV, 3800 Hooper Avenue, Baltimore, Maryland, 21211.